Hey, what's up guys, I'm here and this is the unboxing of Redmi Note 4 in black matte. Just an improved version of Redmi Note 3 with upgraded specifications, improved camera, good price with decent specs and all that. Other contents we get safety information, user guide and a SIM ejector tool for hybrid SIM slot. Next we get a micro USB cable which is seriously disappointing to me. This should provide a USB Type-C cable as it has neither fast charging nor Type-C port. Last thing is a travel adapter which charges at normal rate. Output rate is 5V at 2A. No fast charging, no Type-C. Now getting back to the device. This is totally black from front and back. The back panel is not glossy. It's a fingerprint magnet as it is matte type cover. And I was quite lucky to buy this black variant in first sale. Let's peel off this plastic paper. So satisfactory. The front 2.5D curved glass is looking damn good, but it's not so strong. Just we need a single drop to break its front screen. I will be using this as my primary device, so let me insert my SIM and SD card. It has a hybrid SIM slot, either you can use one nano plus one micro SIM, or you can use one micro SIM and an SD card. Let's boot this up. So while I'm doing the setup wizard, let me give you the physical overview. On the front, it has 5.5 inch full HD display with no glass protection. A 5 megapixel camera which can record videos up to 1080p, but the quality is almost average. There is a 3.5mm headphone jack and an infrared blaster to control your household appliances. On the downside, it has a mic, micro USB charging jack and a speaker grill. Moving on to the right side, it has volume rockers and power button, but they are in black matte design which gives it a unique look but not a unique feel in fingers. And on the left side, there is a hybrid SIM slot. Moving on to the back side, there is 13 megapixel with f2.0 aperture and PDF technology and dual LED flash and a fingerprint sensor. But the speed is almost similar to Redmi Note 3, which is not that much fast. Takes about a second to unlock the device. So the setup has been done and here is the MIUI 8. Initial impressions are quite nice with pre-loaded Xiaomi blockwares, 3 touch type capacitive keys on bottom which are backlit. It's running on Android 6.0.1 and on the top of it, there is a MIUI 8.1.10 skin. And on the first boot, we are getting almost 2.4 GB of RAM free out of 4 GB. And yes, it is a 4 plus 64 GB variant. Talking about the internal specification, it has a Snapdragon 625 which is clocked at 2GHz, Adreno 506 GPU, 4GB RAM, 64GB internal storage, 4100mAh lithium polymer non-removable battery. Now time to test the camera. We can actually record videos in 4K, but you have to use any third-party camera app like OpenCamera to record videos in 4K. I have taken few pics in my studio and in my college, so you can see the results. The picture quality are seriously of average quality, and if we zoom in, then we can easily see the blurriness and pixelated stuffs in pic. So this is the unboxing and quick impressions of the Redmi Note 4. So guys, if you enjoyed this video, then please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe as the review of this phone will come soon. So that's pretty much it. Thank you guys for watching this video and I will see you guys soon in my next video.